In terms of the internal security itself, there are reports, not just Indian intel reports, but also the UN reporting that Pak-based terror groups now joining hands and ranks with the Taliban is a concern. Is that a real concern for India?
Look, Geeta, there were a very large number of Pak nationals who you call them foreign fighters, call them terrorists. They were there. I mean, it's not something I need to say. There are UN reports which speak about them, okay? And speak about them in the thousands. Now, again, you don't need to believe me. Look at some of the debates which are taking place even in the United States, in the Congress, congressional hearings, questions being asked saying, what was the role of Pakistan at this point of time in that situation? And you've seen the responses from the American administration, which are very telling. So things are happening there. I mean, the role of Pakistan in what happened in Afghanistan is not a secret. I mean, it is very, very public. It is more public now because even they now speak about many of these things. So obviously that is a concern for the entire neighborhood. I mean, for the whole region.
Minister Jaishankar, staying with Pakistan for a moment, there's been a ceasefire, between the two sides since February this year. The ceasefire violations themselves, as a result, have gone down, but there are still infiltrations happening. Dialogue hasn't been happening between the two sides for a while now. Could you give us a perspective of your vision of when you think things might sort of get back on track? We know about, a probable back channel and things like that, but is it something that's foreseeable, sir? India and Pakistan talking to each other again?
By the way, I mean, the sense we don't talk is a bit exaggerated. They have an embassy.
Yeah.
We have an embassy. I mean, our foreign ministry talks to the embassy. Their foreign ministry talks to our embassy. So it's not like there is no communication. I mean, diplomats have continued to do what diplomats are supposed to do. I think the issue which you are, in a sense, pointing to was the fact that previously there was a beyond the routine diplomacy engagement on a
yes.
on a certain set of issues. Now, this is not new. Some years ago, 2016 to be precise, the starting from Pathankot and then culminating at Uri, events went in a direction which made it very difficult to continue with that particular mode of engagement. And at the end of the day, there is a big question which all of us need to ask ourselves. When you say, when do you see that coming back? You tell me, when do you see Pakistan becoming a normal country? And for me, a normal country is a country which doesn't sponsor and execute terrorism against its neighbors, which trades with its neighbors on a MFN basis, which has connectivity with its neighbors, which allows people to move on the basis of visas. I mean, the way we do with all our other neighbors. I mean, if I look at a Bangladesh or a Nepal or a Sri Lanka or a Maldives, question is, when do I have something similar with Pakistan? Now, right now, obviously the prospects don't look good. Because the bottom line is that it is the not just the only one of our neighbors. You know, there are very, very few, I mean, to my mind, actually no other situation in the world today where a country actually runs this kind of, scale of terrorism against the neighborhood.